Warning, this review has foul language. Seriously, it starts swearing in like, what, 5 seconds?
Piece of shit car. I got a piece of shit car.
Hello, this is Raging Amish. Did you enjoy the intro? I thought it just fit too well. Anyway, welcome to the RCXD and Black Ops. This is definitely the most interesting killstreak for me to review. The RCXD is one of the most argued point in Black Ops. Some love it, some hate it. I acknowledge this, and trust me, I'm going to touch on the arguments surrounding the RCXD. But I can't really go into the whole argument without saying what the RCXD is. So, let's get the facts out of the way. Available for the cost of 1,200 COD points, the RC car is a 3 killstreak, or a 2 killstreak with hardline. Not to say the obvious statement, but the RCXD is an RC car that you can control and drive around the map. Where the car comes from, I'd love to know. Check the character model. You see any RC car pockets anywhere? Personally, I'm guessing you keep the thing in your anus. Where else could the thing be? But I digress. What's so special about an RC car, you may ask? You could easily crush one of these just by stepping on it in real life. Well, these are no ordinary vehicles. The RCXD comes packed with explosives. The idea of the car is simple. You strap a bomb to an RC vehicle. It goes around the map and blows up anyone unfortunate enough to get close to it. I can summarize the RCXD in one sentence. It's a mobile C4 pack. Literally. Here's a look at the explosive radius. The car does 325 damage at the center, and 25 at the edge of the explosion. The explosion has a radius of 6.5 meters. Once upon a time, it did 400 at the apex, but it's since been nerfed. This is quite important, because now you can survive a car's explosion if you have flak jacket. Let me repeat that. The car has a solid counter. Flak jacket. And if that's not enough for you, you have other counters. There's the jammer, stun grenades, and flash grenades, all of which will short-circuit the car and cause it to jump and hump and go all around. In sharp contrast to the strong explosion, the car itself is very weak. It has only 10 health. You just have to hit it once with any bullet or explosion and it will prematurely detonate. The car has a timer as well. Once you hit the 30-second mark, the RCXD detonates automatically, so find your targets with haste. I don't know about you guys, but this isn't the first time I've seen an RC car with explosives strapped to it. No, I don't have personal experience with an RC car in C4. Trust me, that'd give cow tipping a whole new meaning. No, I'm referring to what I think is the greatest movie series of all time. Tremors. What, you think Treyarch was the first group of people to say, hey, let's strap explosives to a toy? Nah, hell no. Original thought is not Treyarch's forte. Moving on, the car has a lot of special controls to it. You move the car with the left thumbstick and steer with the right. If you want to make a sharp turn, you have a handbrake which you can activate with your left trigger. The car also has a boost function. By tapping the right bumper, the car can boost to help close the gap between it and the enemy. This is a large part of why the RC car is so powerful. If you hit the boost, you can get the jump on your enemy and really surprise them. Last, you can detonate the car at any time by pulling the right trigger. That pretty much sums up the facts, so it's time to bring up the inevitable. Is the car overpowered or a good addition to the Call of Duty series? I already know what most of you think about the car. It probably goes something like this. I think I'm in the minority when I say I actually like the car. I like what it brings to the game, but I'm not going to simply brush aside the arguments from people who don't like this killstreak. Black Ops has issues where I won't budge on my stance, and I'll give you an example. I think the FAMAS AUG and AK-74 all need to be nerfed. I know I haven't reviewed the FAMAS yet, here's why. I'm reviewing it for my 1 year anniversary celebration.
Good. Good idea.
Back to the car. The car is one of those arguments where I truly hear both sides. I understand why some people absolutely loathe this killstreak. You'll just be strolling along, hear the gas engine of doom, and bam, you're dead. I know Flak Jacket is a solid counter, but not every map and game mode calls for that perk. Sometimes it just feels like you got picked at random to die from the RC car, and it doesn't feel fair. To that point, I understand the feeling. I mean, Modern Warfare 2 had a very similar killstreak in the Predator missile. In a lot of ways, the Predator missile was kinda like a flying RC car. The difference here is that the Pred missile was a 5 killstreak. The RC car is a 3 killstreak, making it way easier to attain, and thus making it way more frequent to find on the battlefield. If you don't like the car, I think the solution is to make it a 4 killstreak. Treyarch says that's not possible at this time. Or maybe they said it's not practical. I honestly forget how they phrased it. Still, I call bullshit. Let me simulate what it would take to make the RC car a 4 killstreak. That was easy. I have strong reasons as to why I love the RCXD. You're going to have to bear with me for a couple minutes though, because I'm about to take a huge tangent on the Ghost. If you hear my feelings towards Ghost, I think you'll understand why I like the car. I've touched on this perk in the past. To put it in one blunt statement, I don't think Ghost is overpowered, and to say it's overused wouldn't really be true. Lightweight is actually the most used blue perk, and that makes no sense to me. What's so alluring about this perk that people actually want to use it? It gives extra mobility and no fall damage. Ooh!
I feel I was denied critical need to know information.
But I digress. The odds are the stat sheet that provided that information is older, and let's face it, when the game came out, everybody had lightweight available from the start, so it probably was everywhere. Back on topic, I don't think Ghost is overpowered, but I think its popularity has increased compared to how much people used Cold-Blooded back in Modern Warfare 2. Think back. On a team of 6, you tended to see at most one, possibly two guys using Cold-Blooded. The UAV was useful, and it upped the pace of the game. That has changed in Black Ops. Treyarch weakened the competition for Cold-Blooded, or Ghost as we know it now. I'm not saying the other blue perks are useless, but they definitely don't match the impact of Stopping Power or Juggernaut. Ghost in Black Ops is more popular than Cold-Blooded in Modern Warfare 2. That's a fact. What's up for debate is how this affects the game, and personally, I say it hurts the pace of Call of Duty. On a team of 6, you tend to see anywhere from 2 to 5 Ghosts. I'm not kidding! I kept track over the course of 30 games spread out over 5 game modes, 3 profiles, and 2 systems. The average number of Ghosts I saw in theater mode was 3.5, or 3 to 4 per team. To me, this figure pretty much nullifies the effectiveness of the spy plane, and more importantly, slows the game down. Translation: this makes the game boring. In Black Ops, the stealthy playstyle permeates everywhere because of Ghost's popularity. I'd be okay with this if the game's pace was still high, but the rise of Ghost has encouraged something else that I hate most of all: camping. Few things frustrate me as much as someone camping with Ghost. It is here where the RC car finally enters the picture. I like the RC car because it is the best tool we have for fighting campers.
Doing what I can with what I got.
The RC car lets you drive a C4 pack into a camper's corner and shove explosives right up their ass. It's the ultimate FU. The best part about campers is that if you happen to die to one, you know exactly where they'll be, meaning it's not going to be hard to pick where you're sending your car. Call of Duty will always have its share of campers. That's a given, I'm not stupid. But Black Ops has taken this to a whole different level. In the past, campers tended to pop up on radar, or had to sacrifice stopping power, but that's not true anymore. I feel no remorse for liking the RCXD. As long as camping runs so rampant in Black Ops, I will continue to use these little buggers. Maybe, after hearing my arguments, you get where I'm coming from.
Oh, we get it. We just don't want it.
Bottom line, the strategic promise of the car is my answer to one of the game's biggest evils: camping with Ghost. This killstreak holds tactical promise, and it certainly doesn't hurt that the RCXD is also fun to drive. You're also certainly welcome to disagree with me about the RCXD. I'm not God, and this video is based around my opinion, but I at least hope you understand where my viewpoint comes from. That concludes my review of the RC car. Join me next week, where I'll be covering the HS10. Until then, I bid thee adieu.